Righto, morning peeps, back again at the College Valley. Looking at the weather forecast was going to be a bit rubbish for everywhere. So I picked my walk really, judging by the weather conditions. So it's going to be a nice walk along here. It's cloudy everywhere, so it's going to be nothing about scenic views, it's going to be more about nice, beautiful close-up shots. Nice things to look at. So I was thinking, hey, waterfall. I'll probably get too much waterfalls at my age. A cough or a sneeze and I'll probably get more waterfalls than I should. But I'm going to try and find a nice Three Sisters waterfall up by the Hen Hole. Probably about a 5 mile walk. I haven't had any breakfast this morning, not yet. And I've drank about a half a litre of water on the drive over. So I'm probably an accident waiting to happen, talking about waterfalls. But anyway, I've got myself a nice packed lunch. Nice and quiet, he has only one car in the car park. Nice gentleman, dressed for the weather. He had a nice long dark Macintosh on. He must have been wearing shorts because he just looked like he had bare legs underneath. But aye, nice fella. He was asking us about wanting to go and see his puppies. But I haven't got time for that today. As I say, I've got a walk planned to obviously keep you guys entertained. I'll sign off for now. I think it's going to be a bit of a boring walk until we get to the bits where I haven't walked before. So I'll probably speak to you in a couple of miles. But for now, look how pretty is that. Look at the mist coming off the trees. Oh man, that's lovely. Hello peeps, hasn't been much to report. I'm probably hiked about three and a bit miles. I think I've been on the road about an hour. It's just a bit of a boring gravel track. Scenery's absolutely stunning though. Come on, stop it. Scenery's stunning. I mean, look at that. I'm hoping the waterfalls aren't up there. Never mind if they are. Just past the Mount Hooley Youth Hostel. That seemed nice and quiet. One car there. I was going to crack up on here for a bit. I don't know where I'm going. That's the best part about it. Got a bit of survival gear packed in me trusty backpack this time. Because obviously it's getting, well, that's getting a bit inclement. So I need to pack for emergency type things as well. So I've got a couple of bin bags because they always come in belt are handy. I've got a little bit of gaff tape with this, got two cotton buds and a lighter. So I think I'm sort of covered for every eventuality. So I may as well explain the old bin bags to you. You can never underestimate the importance of two quality bin bags. Need somewhere to sit and it's wet? Not a problem, put a bin bag on it. Need to ford a river and it's too deep and you don't want to get your shoes wet? Not a problem, make yourself a pair of waders out of your bin bags. Get caught in an emergency situation? Not a problem, you can make a sleeping bag out of one bin bag. The other one you can turn into a bivy tent. Start slashing down with rain? Brilliant, grab your bin bag, Zoopman. Make yourself a nice fetching skirt with one, keeps your pants dry. Then you can put another one over the top of you, run your neck obviously, you don't want to suffocate. It'll cover your backpack as well. It's worth splashing out a little bit extra on the bin bags. More water. It's worth splashing a little bit extra out and getting decent bin bags. I've got the £1.40 ones from Aldi. I know I keep advertising Aldi, I don't actually work there. I work for St Oswald's Hospice, on the catering team. Hi peeps. Hi St Oswald's. So if you're ever going to do anything for charity, make sure it's for us, eh? Right, I'm going to crack on here a little bit. Oh, and I'll tell you what else I've got in my survival pack. Spare pair of socks. Folks, I've come across something a little bit weird. So I'm going to investigate. Tell the truth, I'm a little bit feared here. What's going on with that? It's a bit peculiar, isn't it? gonna go and have a look, because I wimped out having a look in the last one. I'm gonna take you with us. A bit of insurance. Which it turned out to be like a cracking little chalet. And they've got electricity in there, and like a telly and that, and a shower. Some coat hanging up for people to wear. Right. Oh well then. You buggers, I'm going in. What's been going on here? Right, I'll set the scene for you. There's some rope on the floor. Next to some stakes. In a bag. Right, so obviously there's been someone tied up here. Been someone tied up here, and they've probably been torturing them. They've been tied up next to that stake. They've been getting the living daylight tortured out of them. I think they've probably scared themselves a bit, and they've defecated in the corner. I don't blame them. They've been catching birds when the birds have been sitting on the roof. Been catching them and just eating them raw, for to stay alive. And then I think they've made themselves like a little ladder when they've got out of the. They've got three of the ropes, they've made themselves a little ladder out of the rope. I think they've climbed up here. As you can see, that's quite high. It's probably about 6.5 foot. I think they've climbed out here. They've smashed the roof there, and they've escaped. Ain't good on them. Tell you what it is, good on them, whoever you are, good on you. And I hope you're living a happy, peaceful life now. I'm getting out of here, it's a bit creepy. Aye. A little bit creepy in there. Aye, they probably ran off this way, haven't they? Aye. They'll have jumped down from there, onto there, and then ran up this way. And I've got that. I probably to this day still living wild and hiding in these here hills, and who could blame them? I'm going to get off now. I'm running a bit low on 720p footage. Yeah, that's knocked the wind out of us a little bit, that. But even if I had to pass it in the dark, I've got me lighter. I'm not going to make a torch out of me cotton buds. So I'd just light one of me cotton buds, and I've got like, the buds at either end. So I can make like a flaming torch twice. Right, it's starting to rain a bit. I'm going to have to stop and put on me new jacket. Got myself a nice windbreaker jacket. Well, I just thought windbreakers were things you got from the chemist when you had a poorly tummy. But apparently not, it's a jacket as well. So anyway, I'm going to stop and put that on now. No idea where I'm going. I'll catch you in a little bit, peeps. I'll start the lash dune. Ciao! Right, folks, as you can see, I've got my hood up. I've got my windbreaker on. It's actually got more polyester in it than cotton. It's the first time I've ever bought anything with this much polyester in. But I'll tell you what, it's keeping the wind off nicely. Your seat's just blew away. I've had to stop here for a little rest because I was getting a little bit faint because I've had nothing. Well, I drove all the way from Newcastle to Woola and then probably walked about 5 miles to get here without having any breakfast. So I've just been having a little sit down here on my bin bag. Having myself a Kit Kat and a carton of apple juice. But I'll show you where we are, folks. Look. Oh, look at that. Look where little Donna is. Look what little Donna can see. Waterfalls! Camera's getting wet. Them cotton buds will come in handy. Ciao for now! Rah! Look at the smashing poncho I've made out of me bin bag. That's why you should always bring bin beaners with you when you're out on a country hike. Hey man, I found the waterfalls. And they're not just running off the end of my nose. But I think I'm quite pulling this off. I might get the other bin bag out soon and make myself a pair of culottes. Because I'm getting quite wet, really. But what the hell? It's not one thing, it's another. It all adds up to the adventure. I'll see you in a little bit, peeps. Donovan Senior, reporting from... wet College Valley, but looking absolutely resplendent in a homemade poncho. Ciao for now, peeps. I'll see you at the waterfall. Woo! Hey, just want to see the waterfall. How cool's that, man? That's worth the little hike, eh? Oh, yes. Tough little Donna. Selfie stick, and the battery compartment's fallen off, and my selfie stick threaded the bottom of the camera. But wow, look at that! I'm just gonna find myself a spot for first dinners and crack on up a little bit. That is brilliant. Woo! On the whole, right? Not a bad idea going on a wet day. I say me selfie stick's knackered, look, it just flops around. Can't be arsed with stuff like that, that's why I got rid of the husband. No, I'm only kidding, no more smutty ones. Wow, just wow for this place, look what's coming up. Yes, a National Geographic moment, folks. To be honest, it's blinking noisy. I don't know if I want first dinners here. But how cool is that? I actually have walked the last mile dressed like this. Stunning. I must look a right picture from above. Tell you what though, I'm toasty warm and nice and dry. Some nice clothes like this from a mountain shop, that would have cost you a fortune. I was looking at about 30 pence from Aldi. Aldi, all the top tips. Coming back down the wood. A creepy shack. Found a different path. I'm fairly blind down here. So it took us 3 hours to get up to the waterfalls. Hopefully it'll not take us 3 hours to get back down to the van. I'll probably not be doing much more filming because, like I say, that's like a bit of a knock really. Walking along with me hand out. Only I can't afford a selfie stick, but I've got a very good one. But my camera's packed in. I'll say bye for now. It's been a really canny day. I don't care what the weather's like. Look at us, man. How much fun am I having? What are you doing? I don't want to know. Anyway, my camera's knackered. If anyone's got a spare cheap camera with HD video properties and would like to swap for a couple of big well slices, oh yeah man, that would just be so appreciative. Just messages on Facebook. Right, I'll probably get you a pack of 6 big well slices, that'd be that. I'll be that appreciated. Right folks, in a bit. Thankfully I've got dry socks and dry pants in that bag in the van. Yeah. Because I'm a professional rambler. I'm not a reckless rambler. Yeah, I am quite a reckless rambler. Yeah, I think he's now in a van. Lady in the orange van, aka the reckless rambler. Right, Donovan Senior reporting from College Valley. Looking at like $1 million. Find a nicer way down, gonna sneak past the creepy shack. Watch out this parkour. I'll catch up with you in a bit, peeps. I'm not me dinner yet, I'm starving, there's nowhere nice to sit. And I'm not going in that shack. I might just have to keep me dinner till I get back the van. No wonder I'm as thin and sulfate as I am. Alright then, in a little bit, peeps. Ciao!